you have any ideas on how to grab that vase?
I'm sure a caring gentleman like yourself has a plan.
Nice. Does she have anything else to say?
Do you have any ideas on how to grab that vase?
I'm sure a clever fellow like you can figure it out.
Okay, so she thinks I'm clever, and she thinks I'm caring. Am I just gonna grab the vase now, or am I supposed to figure out where these other things go? Because it seems like we're supposed to put things back, right? But...
It was cold at the top.
Burn the books. Yeah, I wish I could climb these stairs. Really just kind of sliding along here. And obviously the canvas goes here, but I don't have an option to put it there. Okay. I guess maybe we're supposed to just get this thing first. Oh, there's another door there. Let me just screw with this thing.
You're not- that didn't fit there. Now's not the time for that. Round peg, square, that didn't fit there.
Alright. What's this door? Oh, there's two of them. I can't go to them. Seriously?
Round peg? That didn't fit. Now's not the time for that. You're not fooling. Round peg?
Okay. I, don't know. There must be something around here that I've missed then.
Shame. It looked like the loot cracked in the tumble and was in need of a repair.
Well, I would love to put everything back and fix everything, but I can't put anything anywhere.
It was cold. All I knew how to make was chocolate chip.
So we have pictures. I have a puzzle book. I have a magical world book. I have a crossword and riddles book. I have a canvas. I have these things that I can look at, but it doesn't look like I could truly interact with them in any way. I'm obviously missing something. I would grab this broom. Truly I would. And you'd think that I could put these books back. Right? Because these are where all the books are. But no. And you'd think that I put the canvas here. Because that's an easel? It's an easel, right? Yeah, just... nope. Wait.
Do you have any ideas on how to grab that vase?
I'm sure a caring gent.
I thought... Wait.
Don't go up there!
But... There might be an item up there that can help me.
Hey, were you invited up there?
Well... Let me go up
Do
there.
Do you have any ideas on how to grab that vase?
I'm sure.
I just figured out how to get... Climb the steps.
This puzzle box busted in the fall and...
So all these things need to be fixed. Books need to be put back. This needs to be fixed. That needs to be fixed. And this is cold. It's cold here. I put the canvas over to block the air from coming through. I have stairs I can't climb up. The hell, game?
Sat just outside the boundaries of a spell keeping me inside the tower.
The thing that's crazy about these doors, they're inside, but I can't even try to go in there. I mean, if we can't go in there, make the spell. Make the spell have them on the other side? On the outside of the tower. Uh-huh.
All I knew how to make was chocolate chip.
Now's not the time for that. Round peg, you're not fooling me.
Oh, that's Vee's. She loves logic puzzles. Ask her where it goes.
Okay, got it. Now I know what to do. Okay, she likes the puzzles.
I'll finish it someday. Until then, it goes over there.
I knew that. The game wouldn't let me.
The hidden magical world. Each page brings me more joy than the last.
Aww.
Can you put that over there?
I was trying to do that too.
That belongs to Vee. I can't stand that game. Ask her where to put it.
Exactly. Who can stand these puzzles?
That didn't fit there. You're not fooling me. That didn't fit there.
Okay. So the puzzles... So now I can finally put this here? Makes a lot of sense.
Appreciate it. Very nice.
Got here drums, like bongo drums. So I fulfilled her quests first.
Bongos. Perhaps they go with the kitchenware.
Okay, you got puzzle things.
My dad and I used to play this game for hours. It goes on that shelf.
It's not really a shelf, but okay.
I read that at least 3 times a year. Could you put it back over there?
You read it? All the puzzles are solved.
Appreciate it.
I guess something happens if we do it wrong. They complain or something. Whoops.
Appreciate it.
Oh, bones. Them bones. Pair of bones.
Some sort of nunchuck made of bone. At least it was a self-sustainable business model.
Yeah, right. Kill people with the nunchucks and then make more nunchucks out of those bones. Bone chucks. Right. Alright, let's see if they have anything else to say.
Do you have any ideas on how to grab that vase?
I'm sure.
Alright, never mind. I guess we'll try to grab the vase with the bone chucks. I'm just trying random crap, really. Alright, let's go.
You're not fooling me. Now's not the time for that.
Okay. I guess we're just gonna... Unless I'm gonna play the bongos for this... Squirrel.
Round peg.
Wait. Here we go.
That didn't fit. You're not fooling.
Okay. I guess we're asking them about the bone chucks and stuff. She's the one who's into music, so.
My bongos! OB says these are nothing but treble. Can you put them back over there?
On that. Oh, in there. Okay. I thought she meant the table. Where? Where? Past the table. Here? No. What are we looking at? Over here, right? Oh, I didn't even have to click on him. Okay. I can take this thing. Oh, I got some kind of acorn. Yes. Alright, so... I guess the bone chucks are V's, but... We'll see what she says.
Those are V's. She never lets me touch them. She'll know where to put them.
Nah. What about this acorn?
That didn't fit there.
doesn't fit there. What am I trying to shove it up her butt or something? All right.
Now's not the time for that.
What can I say? As an only child, I was in constant need to keep myself entertained.
Whose bones are they? How rude, she just points there. Oh, in here?
Appreciate it.
Look at that. I want that. Nice. We've got a poleaxe. Long spear.
Round peg, square hole.
Well, that's where it came from. Oops.
You're not fooling me. That's...
not where that goes. Okay, so let's see if we can use this then to get this. Would make sense that it would work. Nice.
Wow, not too shabby. Excellent work, Graham. Hmm.
What's this hmph?
It's Hagatha! You better hide!
Oh, not that Hagatha witch.
Oh, I can't stand that soggy woman. Won't even speak to her.
Vee, that's not very nice.
Might not be nice, but it's true.
You've never been one to give the time of day to people you don't like.
Seriously, she looks like a melted marshmallow.
A melted marshmallow. Good God.
Oh, how are my delicate little flowers?
We're splendid, Hagatha. Thank you.
Looks like you lovelies missed a spot.
Quick, move around the table.
What was that?
House of Pinocchio?
Nothing.
That's right, dearie. A good princess should keep her thoughts on the inside. Just like we practiced.
His cape. I moved him there. So yeah, that was me.
Out of place?
Am I gonna get a chance to whisper again?
Aftershock?
Should I go upstairs? Can I go upstairs?
Oh, sweetie. We'll need to continue working on your awkward bungling.
I've been working on my sleep kit.
Looks like my garden needs to be weeded.
Zods, this part went so smoothly the last time I told it.
Oh, missed that. Sorry, guys.
That's right, dearie. A good princess should keep her thoughts on the inside. Just like we practiced.
I can't skip this?
Oh, sweetie. We'll need to continue working on your awkward bungling.
I've been working on my sleep giggles, too.
Perfect. Perfect. Now, where was I?
Behind the...
Oh, yes. That smell. From over there.
Okay, I can't move now, so yes, that's a good place to be.
Yes. What do we have here?
Hagatha, would you like
to... interrupt? It's rude.
Yeah, I can't move now.
Slimy cucumber.
Gotcha.
Can't just open it like a normal person? And she's gonna turn around and look at the girls and...
Oh!
Right,
looks like another princess is trying to party.
Princess?
Long flowing gown.
What?
Skin with rose-colored cheeks, an elaborate headdress, and... wait. Oh, the scent of lavender. I recognize a princess when I see one.
Seriously?
Welcome to my tower. I'd invite you to dinner, but you don't really have a choice. Hagatha.
Wait.
Good one.
She's not really fooled, is she? Because the other time she spotted us, she was not fooled. But now because we're standing there with them? Are you eating a turnip or is that your nose? I'm delighted to make your acquaintance, I guess.
Delighted to make your acquaintance.
Oh, what a sweet little princess. Need to work on your grace, though. Mm. Now come. It's time to eat.
Yeah, this makes a lot of sense.
Hummus face.
Hush.
Hummus face.
What's everyone feel like for dinner?
Maybe
Aren't
hummus?
Savory. Sweet, please.
After dinner, Hagatha excused herself and told us to get our beauty rest like all good princesses should. The sun was setting, but none of us were sleepy.
What's this?
He suggested we play a game to pass the time. Neese picked out Moral Quarrel, a casual social game. Vee preferred something more competitive, but begrudgingly went along with it.
Moral Quarrel.
All right. The first step is we answer all the cards in front of us. We must answer honestly, or the game won't work.
Okay.
A magical genie offers you one of two very specific wishes. A, you can live one life that lasts 1,000 years. Or B, you can live 10 lives that last 100 years. Which do you choose?
Come on with it. This is the easy part.
Okay, okay. One life?
You are a royal guard on the lookout for an evil sorcerer that has been terrorizing villagers. When you finally apprehend this sorcerer, you discover he is Charles, your childhood best friend. Do you A, tell Charles to leave town and never return, or B, throw your friend in the castle dungeon?
Terrorizing? Just terrorizing, right? Okay. A.
Would you rather A, have a pet dragon, or B, be a dragon?
Be a dragon.
I'd be a dragon with a pet dragon. Is that weird?
It's not an option, sorry.
Would you rather A, have a tail that never stops loudly tapping against the ground, or B, have noodles for hands? Well, that wouldn't allow you to pick up anything.
Dragons have tails, so tail.
Yeah, tail.
Would you rather A, constantly reek of syrup and not smell it, or B, constantly smell reeking syrup?
I actually like the smell of syrup.
How are these actual moral quandaries? I mean, the other one with the
you
friend
still need
was.
More time? Good thing we went with such a simple game.
Oh, shush you. A, I mean, at least I'm okay.
First, we mix up our hands. At the start of our turn, we choose which player we want to try to pair with. We'll then ask the question from the card at the top of our decks. If both asker and askee answer the same way, they both place the card on one of the three spaces between them. Once there are three cards between the two players, they both win the game. If there's not a match between players, the card must be discarded. If a player runs out of cards before matching three, they lose. Graham, are you getting all this?
Maybe.
Which one is it? Is it Vee? Is it Neese? Do they like me? Do I like them? What does my breath smell like? Oh, lavender. And, eggs. We're inside. Should I take my hat off? What if they don't like capes? That's silly. Everyone loves capes. What if they're allergic to triumph? Please tell me this is my inside voice.
What are you thinking about?
Oh, nothing. Just in my relaxed box.
Ready to begin? Graham, you start.
A magical genie offers you one of two very specific wishes. A, you can live one life that lasts 1,000 years. Or B, you can live 10 lives that last 100 years. Which do you choose?
...100% B.
I don't agree. I wouldn't feel comfortable changing who I am in all those lives.
Graham. A rich merchant inadvertently drops one shiny gold coin on the ground. You see a poor hungry orphan pick it up. Do you A, convince the orphan to be honest and return the coin, or B, turn your head the other way and let the orphan keep the coin?
Be honest, because you're teaching the kid to be honest as well.
A, I figured their honesty would be rewarded with more than just one shiny gold coin.
Nice. I chose A too. The orphan learned a valuable lesson, and would probably be rewarded for their honesty too.
Graham? You have been hunting for your starving family all day, and only managed to catch a small goose. On your way back home, a hungry beggar offers you magic beans in return for the goose. The beggar tells you that the beanstalk sprouted from his beans will lead you to a chest that produces unlimited food. He would go after it himself, but his legs are too tired and old. Do you, A, kindly reject the offer and bring your starving family their dinner? Or B, let the beggar eat the goose and plant the beans in your yard.
Sounds like she likes B.
B? I mean, magic beans.
Yep. Magic beans.
Magic beans.
Okay, Tide.
You are a royal guard on the lookout for an evil sorcerer that has been terrorizing villagers. When you finally apprehend this sorcerer, you discover he is Charles, your childhood best friend. Do you A, tell Charles to leave town and never return, or B, throw your friend in the castle dungeon?
Now, I chose A. I really don't know.
I pick A.
Okay,
I agree. Charles should be banished for the crimes he committed. But I couldn't imprison a friend.
Neese? It says, you are the kingdom's wizard doctor. In the middle of the night, an honorable knight and despicable thief arrive at your door. The thief's injuries are much more severe than the knight's. Do you A, heal the knight first, or B, heal the thief first?
I picked A. The honorable knight served our kingdom well, and he deserves to be healed.
I picked B. I would honor my medical oath to serve those in need first.
Interesting.
The... Oh, this is pretty on the nose. A man you've never met, but is known as a friendly king, sends for your hand in marriage. A, accept his invitation, trusting his reputation, or B, seek love on your own.
Is there any other answer than B?
Of course. I chose the same.
Would you rather A, have a pet dragon, or B, be a dragon?
I'm thinking Neese would rather be a dragon. So, by... If I win with her, does that choose who the queen who Graham's gonna marry is? Or is this just a game? That's what I've been wondering this whole time. Be a dragon.
I pick B.
Ah la la.
Yep, I've always dreamed of flying and breathing fire and treasure. I love treasure.
Neese and I won the game.
Nice.
She looked like she was wholly in a victory dance. B looked upset. Not because of me, but because she hated to lose.
Well, cry. Looked like she was crying.
When the sun went down, the air turned frigid. We decided it was too cold to play another game, and headed to bed.
Is a bed there?
The walls of the tower were pretty thin, and embarrassing as it is to admit, that night I overheard the princesses talking about me.
I pretty much like this chapter.
So, what do you think of King Graham the Wise? I'm not sure about him yet. What do you think?
He's interesting.
This seemed like the perfect time to explore the tower. I was interested in getting to know my new home better.
I mean, I don't know if we're even halfway done yet, but so far I prefer this to the second. Oh, these retract like that? Like gears. It's so weird. Yeah, so far I like this better than the second chapter. I mean, it was still fun, I enjoyed it, but it was a lot of, I don't know, the whole time running out thing bothered me with the second chapter.
I wasn't ready for bed yet. There was still more to explore.
Some of these fell, I guess, unused steps or something. Okay, what can we explore? Look at these bare shelves.
This puzzle box busted in the fall and could use some fixing.
Maybe we're gonna get a chance to fix it though.
Shame. It looked like the loot cracked.
That's... Oh! Wait.